the Better Business Bureau lowered me from an A-plus to an
L. Sad.
You know, it is sad that they would, that companies do stuff like that out there.
For a man who professes faith, for you to lie like this is really extraordinary to me. The Better Business Bureau looked at your advertising.
I'll stand by the truth. And that is the truth. This was all, every time I get attacked, it's because of political reasons.
Okay. Just so our viewers know, what you were doing is you were running two-for-one giveaway ads saying, oh, you know, two-for-one, two for the price of one. And you were doing that so often that it actually became the regular price. And when people actually looked, there were so many complaints. When people looked, wait a minute, the actual price, if you double the price, it's the same as your,
two-for-one offer.
It wasn't a sale offer.
No,
and you were running
you
it for so long, that became the regular price. And that's why you were downgraded to an F, because it was misleading.
No, here's what it was, Anderson. I met with the Better Business Bureau in the spring, in that fall, and they said to me, I said, what do you mean I can't have a sale price on my pillow, a regular suggested retail and a regular price? And they go, but you're your own manufacturer, Mike. And I go, so if I made my stuff in China, I would be okay? And they said, yes. I said, you all ought to be ashamed of yourself.
That's not what they said.
I said, you just will give me an F because nobody's going to believe this, that you're telling me I can't give a great special to my customer.
They published their report. Anybody can look at it, and they will know you're not telling the truth.
Well, the whole country, I stand with an F. It's fantastic. The Better Business Bureau is one of the most corrupt organizations in our country. It's pay per play. If you give them money, they give you a good rating. I don't stand for
you,
that kind of stuff.
You make money manufacturing masks, right?
No, I gave away $4 million out of my own pocket. That's a fallacy.
Well, that's
$4
nice.
Million,
that's good.
Dollars,
that's impressive.
And you can check those facts. $4 right. million dollars out of Mike Lindell's pocket, donated.
Your company,
how many people out there can claim that?
The mask that you're making, you actually don't wear a mask. You have actually proudly said that you don't need to wear a mask because you take this product.
That's correct, but I do wear a mask when I'm supposed to, and if I'm around other people, to be respectful, because they don't know that I can't give it, I can't give them that, and I cannot get the virus.
Dr. William Schaffner, an infectious disease specialist at Vanderbilt University, who actually has a medical degree, worked as an epidemic intelligence service officer with the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, says, and I quote, about this product, don't take it. Stay away. This is quackery. Do not take medicines of any kind to either prevent this infection or treat it that hasn't been vetted very, very carefully by the scientific community. You're saying the president of the FDA or Americans at large should listen to you and not people like Dr. Schaffner and other reputable doctors out there who haven't taken money to promote supplements in the past.
Dr. Schaffner is misconstrued. This has already had all its safety tests, and it's before the FDA.
That is just a complete lie. That is just a bald-faced lie. It has not had.
No, it's not. And when you're proven wrong, Anderson, you're going to have me back on your show when everything I'm saying is truthful.
Has it been tested in animals, sir? Has it been tested in humans and peer-reviewed studies?
It's been tested in humans. 100% of tests has been done in humans.
Peer-reviewed studies.
It's not published yet, but the FDA has it right now. You just don't know about it because you tried to take a narrative and tried to hurt me and the president and Dr. Ben Carson.
Why wouldn't you publicly... Why shouldn't the public be able to see these alleged studies that you claim
exist? Ask the FDA. It's with the FDA right now. I don't know what you want me to do. It's been sitting with the FDA since.
Did you give them all the copies of the study? You don't have one that you read? You said you read one.
All I'm doing is telling the public it works.
So
I 100% believe it. And it saved my family and friends' lives.
You said you read the study. I want you to see. I'm following up. Did you actually read the study?
The one that I read was the 1,000 people they did the safety test on, which has been done since 2016.
Where were people tested? Who conducted the study?
You'll have to look. I don't have it in front of me, but it'll come out. Maybe you should
investigate
that.
You don't remember anything about what you read?
What's that? 1,000 people, a safety test.
Okay, besides 1,000 people, you don't remember anything about the study.
Yeah, absolutely. When you test a supplement, when it goes on the dietary list, they do studies of how much you can take before you start getting side effects. This was 50 times more was given to people that have pancreatic cancer.
If this is does make it onto the supplement list, if this would be sold as a dietary supplement, that's how you'll skirt this, you won't actually be able to advertise it as for COVID-19, correct? You would just put it on as a dietary supplement, and by going out and doing a lot of publicity, you would just hope that people would use it off-label, believing it had COVID benefits, and you will profit financially. That seems to me the theory.
Nobody said what's going to happen. Or it's in for both, or it's in for an IND, which we're waiting on. The FDA knows it passed every safety test. They could give it to us today on the dietary list. We would like the IND, which we applied also for the drug side. And
why should the FDA be wasting time on something like this? Has no proof of anything. The military, actually looked into this, tested it. And said,
Anderson,
it's inconclusive. We're not going to do further testing because it's a waste of time. We have more important things
to do. No, that's not what they said. The FDA is doing a fine job, like the president said. They're the ones that have all this. They're
doing that is what the military said at Fort Detrick. They actually did test it. They said it was inconclusive and that they are not doing any further testing because there's a lot more important things for them to be looking at.
No, the FDA has gotten everything from the company. They've gotten everything. Tests you don't get to see right now because you're not the FDA, Mr. Anderson. When it comes out, when
but
the
you
FDA
got to
gives
see
us
it.
The IND. You know, I'm going to ask you this.
You got to see a study, but you don't remember anything about it. You don't remember who did it.
Mr.
You don't remember
Anderson,
what their control group.
What do you think I'm on here for? If you knew yourself that by coming on and getting this name out there, why are you trying to discredit a thing that works? Why, when we have such a great
because
president
no
that
evidence,
brings all
sir.
Private sector companies into this and to reach out for all solutions.
Because you're a snake oil salesman telling people, take this product.
Calling,
you're desperate.
You're
calling
me desperate. Names. I don't call you names. I don't call your network names. Why are you attacking me?
Because you are telling people who are desperate to take something that is unproven, potentially dangerous, and you have no evidence to back it up. It's kind of morally bankrupt.
The only thing I've done is I've given it to my friends and family to save their lives, and I'm not telling you to take anything. I'm telling you when the FDA approves it.
You want to get it on shelves for people to take.
No, when the FDA approves this, it's going to save millions of lives. And we just hope it gets out there fast, that they get the approval done for the IND. I just want to see people save lives and get back to normalcy in this country so that, we sit here with crippled as a country. And here's the solution. That's all.
You know, I think when a lot of people hear, I know you're the finance chairman for President Trump in Minnesota?
No. I'm campaign chairman for Minnesota with the horrific things that have gone in Minnesota. I'm so glad that he appointed me because I'm going to get the word out of how bad our government has been in Minnesota, our governor and mayor that stuck to this whole thing with riots, decisions.
What people find upsetting is that because you have the ear of the president, you are put on the board of this company and get a financial stake in this
product. That's a lie. I don't have the ear of the president on that.
You didn't help arrange a meeting with the president and folks in this company?
The task force did. Ben Carson's on the task force. I was in there. He was in there.
You took it to Ben Carson. You got Ben Carson to go with you to the president with somebody from this company.
No, Ben Carson was informed of this on Easter Sunday. He's part of the task force. Anything I hear good out there, I bring it to the task force.
You attended a meeting, though, with the president and Ben Carson and people from this company, right?
One person and he just wanted to be informed like he does on every good cure.
So
anything that's out there, our
that's
president
the reason
reached
you were
out
brought,
and wants to...
That's the reason you were brought into the company because you have the ear of the president.
You're willing to promote this and make all sorts of claims. No, the company brought me in because they said, our passion, this amazing small company full of great Christians, and they want to help humanity. And they came to me knowing I know how to scale something to the masses and get it out to everyone. As soon as the FDA approves
it, you know how to sell something. You know how to promote a product.
No, I don't need to sell it. This will be out. I won't need to sell this. This will go out to every hospital, and every person that needs help. When the FDA approves it, it'll go out to everybody. I don't have.